Hey guys, so the King Tiger for the Knispel commemoration buddy build that I'm doing with Jonas Coleman is finished. All that's left to do on it is the placement weathering and pigments and dirt effects, so it blends into the diorama, which I also just finished. And all that's left to do on the diorama is the pigments to, again, tie the vehicle and figure elements together. And the only thing left to do on the whole build is the figures and stowage, which probably be a couple of days before I finish that. So, and I'll show you all this now, I guess. So this will be probably the second last video for this series. So the I don't remember what this thing looked like the last time you saw it. I don't actually remember. I'd have to go look at the videos. So she's got all of her washes on. She's got all of her camo on. Actually, not. That's what it was. She just had her camo paint on. So after I did the camo, the last time you saw her, I did an all-over wash. It's not a sludge wash, but it's a little bit lighter with burnt umber. And then I flat coated it and did a pin wash with more burnt umber. And then I did UMP dark dirt wash on the Zimmerit. And then came next. Oh, the grease and oil stains I did. And then I did the rust that you see on there, all the rust streaks for the larger chips. I didn't go crazy on those because it's supposed to be a newer vehicle, so she'd have anything that got scratched would rust overnight. Anything that got scratched and rusted overnight within 2 days, it would start to streak. So, they didn't have a whole lot in the way of, they didn't have like Rust-Oleum or anything like that. There's no rust check back then, so things rusted fairly quickly when it was exposed to the air. And it's a tank, so it got scratched up and a little bit beat along its softer parts like side skirts and stuff like that. Then what did I do next? It was pigments. I did a dot filter. That's what it was. Some yellow, some green, and some blue. Dot filter the entire thing, and then I did the, and then I flat coated it again because it had picked up a bit of a shine from the filters. And then I added a dark yellow filter, oil filter to the whole thing to tie the two camo colors together. Then I flat coated it one more time, the final time, and then I started with the pigments. And then that was about it. The pigments are just a couple of different dirt colored pigments. And they're just made from ground chalk. So, and I matched them as close to pictures of Normandy soil that I could find. So nothing complicated. Then I took some of this is dried baby's breath that Forbes Hutton had sent me. He got it from MK35 in France and painted it green. And it's actually an element of part of the diorama. Sorry about the pinging there. Somebody's sending me messages. I didn't go crazy on it. I only added two little sprigs of it because the diorama is quite thick with this stuff, so I didn't want to go nuts. I just wanted to add an element of artificial or the natural camo or the foliage stuck in a couple of pieces of the tank is all I wanted. After I built the tank, I realized that I had forgotten to attach the two little clamps that go right here that hold the track or the towing cable on. And I was like, I don't know. Crap, the painted or the tank had already been weathered and all that. And I was like, I don't really want to blend that in. So I added some primer color paint so it looks like they had actually just broken off. And at least that's what I hope. Anyway. That was a pretty big mistake on my part. So, but either way, nothing I can do about it now. I can't think of anything else. Yeah, I think that was it. This figure here, I've had him sitting around for quite some time. He needs a little bit of pigments so that he's tied in with the surroundings. He's a little stark right now, only because he doesn't have any pigments that tie him into the features of the tank. Just basically the same colors I used to pigment down here. He need to go on his boots and on the lower parts of his pants. And that's about it. The same thing will be done with the figures when I finish those. And then when I go to attach the vehicles to the diorama, the same pigments will be transferred between the vehicle and the diorama so that they're the same. I think that's about all she wrote on this. Now, there's another vehicle that I'm adding to the diorama. And you'll probably see that in a moment or two. So now I'm going to go and get the diorama, and I'll bring that over and show you guys what that looks like, and I'll talk about that for a minute. Of it is I can actually fit into the viewfinder without it looking too small and you can't see anything. These trees are more of the baby's dried baby's breath that I mentioned that I got from Forbes Hutton. These straighter ones that kind of look a little bit like a pine, I got those from Rodney Hickey in Newfoundland. He sent me a whole box of those things. I don't think either of us actually know what they are. He had them hanging upside down in his greenhouse, and he thought I could put them to use, so he sent them to me, and yeah, I'm really liking them. He says he's got more, so yay! I think they worked out well. They come in, they're like a dark brown color, and I have to paint them up. I use like three different colors on all of these to try and give them a little bit of a variety. So they're not all the same color. Now, for the diorama itself, if you notice there's a void, which is right here. That's where the other vehicle is going to go, which I'll show you in just a minute. The base is just a piece of old shelving. I covered that in carpenter glue, and then put a thick layer of, well, not thick, it was probably maybe 3 millimeters thick, 4 millimeters thick, of DAS modeling, air dry modeling clay, which I've used many times and talked about many, many times. Then I shaped that into the road surface, because there's an actual road that goes through here. And I'll show you a picture here of what it looks like. So there's that road, which you'll see more defined once I add the pigments, because the pigments will actually define it further from the sides, so it won't be just all gray and stuff like that. Anyway, so I sculpted it into the road shape, and then I added high sides for where the forest area starts. Then waited that for to dry a little bit, about 20-25 minutes. Then on top of that, I embedded some gravel stones that I scraped up off the side of the road. It's like fine crushed gravel, like crusher dust kind of thing, but a little bit more coarse and not so uniform. And then I added some kitty litter, the non-clumping stuff, and a couple of different kinds of sand, just to add texture, and some talus, I added that. And kept it kind of random. And then once that had dried into the DAS, I sprayed the whole thing with some white glue, liquefied white glue, to let it soak in and harden. And then I embedded all the trees and then pulled them all out so that there's holes. And I marked off where these are not fence posts. These are where figures go. That's what these little cocktail sticks are. So everywhere you see a cocktail stick, that's where a person's going to be standing. It's supposed to be like that. What came next? Oh, then I painted the whole surface. At first I primed it with Vallejo black primer. That's pretty much all I use Vallejo primer for now, is for painting dioramas. This is just my opinion. In my opinion, that's all Vallejo's good for. Vallejo primer, I can't trust it on a model anymore. It's too unpredictable. It doesn't do what it's supposed to do. So, I have since found much better and more reliable primers, and I use those instead. So, so I primed it all in the black primer, and I used black because it adds shadow. Anywhere I don't get with paint or covering later, it'll add a shadow effect, and that's what I want to do. So once that dried, I added a bunch of different earth tone, like browns and light browns, dark browns, some grays and stuff. Just sprayed kind of almost, not quite randomly, but I followed the roadbed, right, making a roadway pattern. And then I added some greens to where the grass was going to go and where the forest was supposed to sit. And then I let that dry. Once it had dried, I added some liquefied white glue to the areas where I was going to actually put grass. And I added two colors of static grass together and sprinkled it onto the areas where the white glue was. And then I added some tufts, I don't know if you'd be able to see them, tufts of grass, three different colors of tufts of grass. And then some sprinkles of an emerald colored foam that's ground up really, really fine for like a moss. Some dried parsley leaves, some oregano, some thyme, some coriander for flowers. Like really, really tiny flowers and stuff like that. I added those in there. And then I used my rubberized horsehair in there. And old man's beard for bushes. Painted those green. What else? A couple of logs I threw in there. And I painted those up. It's really hard to see them though. When I do the photos later on, you'll be able to see all that stuff. So, I think that's that. So now I'll just go and get the last vehicle and show you guys what that looks like. Okay, so that's the last vehicle that I'm going to put in there. And you'll recognize that as being the SWS, the 3.7 centimeter SWS from the Great Wall Hobby Appreciation Group build. I thought it would add a bit of interest to the scene. I was actually thinking about adding a second King Tiger, because that's what's in the picture. There's a think there was a Schwimmwagen or a Kubelwagen, and a couple of other, you can see other vehicles in there, like small utility vehicles, but it's hard to tell exactly because the picture's somewhat blurry, but most you can tell there's a bunch of King Tigers hiding in the trees. But the King Tiger I ordered was the wrong one, and didn't arrive in time, so not much I could do about it. So anyway, but I finished this, and it's very close to the same state of weathering, and the camouflage is, and the colors are close, so that's why I picked it. And the style of build is similar, so my skill style is the same. That's why I paired them together. And the figures, there will be a couple of figures coming through here, and then some figures standing in front of here. Then I'm going to have some stowage elements piled around. You'll see what those are when I get around to finishing them. I'm not quite done yet. And you'll see them actually in the final reveal. So this is where it's sitting now. I'd say it's probably maybe another week or a week and a half before I have this finished. So it's done, 2 months earlier than I expected it to be. I expected this thing to go to mid-April, but because I don't have that much else going on at the same time, I was able to finish it a lot quicker. So, but as things go, I'm fairly happy with it. It floats my boat so far. I'm really happy with the way some of these things turned out, like these trees. I really like the way they look. They did a lot more than I thought they were going to do, so I'll be using those a lot more, and probably in different combinations and hopefully in different methods. I have a plan on using them in a totally different way here soon. Something else I'm working on. We'll see what happens. Hopefully it works, but it remains to be seen. So anyway, so this is what she looks like now, and hopefully in about a week or so she'll be finished and you guys will see the final reveal. Anyway, I guess I'll talk to you later. Bye for now. Keep your stick on the ice.